Canberra has declared war on human traffickers with new laws designed to stamp out the modern-day slave trade. It follows our exclusive story last night that revealed the horrible treatment of victims right here in Sydney. Tonight, Matt Doran continues his expose on this troubling story.
I present the Crimes Legislation Amendment Slavery, Slavery-like Conditions and People Trafficking Bill 2012.
The tough new laws are a reflection of Australia's appeal to human traffickers, most of them syndicate criminals sourcing women and children from Southeast Asia, Korea and China to work in Australia's sex trade.
Some critics have asked, won't this just force this underground? And I have to say to them that it is already underground now.
The legislation dramatically increases the powers of police to prosecute in a range of industries. The key change is a forced labour offence for cases not linked to sexual servitude. There's a new law for helping or harbouring traffickers and another for forced marriage. And for the first time, Australia has a law against organ harvesting.
There's your mums and dads who bring a domestic worker into their home. There's more organised syndicates who are involved in transnational networks.
The Greens want better support for victims and are insisting the bill be put before a Senate inquiry.
We need to make sure they have all the support in terms of access to temporary and permanent visas. If they don't get that, we won't be seeing people come forward.
These are the headquarters of Australia's anti-trafficking teams.
She was forced to work up to 17 hours a day in a couple's shop in their private home.
And here, the legislation's been well received.
The bar of what effectively is human trafficking will be lowered, and I would suspect that there'll be obviously more convictions as a result.
The laws should come into effect later this year. Matt Doran, 10 News.